In this video, I will walk you through the import and assembly of a set of spot trace files. My dataset contains 26 applied biosystems spot trace files. In order to import and assemble these trace files in one import round, the trace files should be present in the same folder, and file names should contain the sample names. In my example database, I press the import button in the toolbar to call the import dialog. I select the option Import and Assemble Trace Files under Sequence Type Data and press the import button. In the first step, I need to browse for the files. I select all files and click Open. All files are displayed in the input dialog. The way the information should be imported in the database needs to be specified with an import template. I can select one of the default templates or create my own. As this is the first time I will import and assemble spot traces in this database, I will create a new import template. The only source of information available in the newly created import template is the file name. I will link the file name to the BioNumerics key field. If I now press the preview button, I can check the rule that I have defined so far. From the preview, I can see that not the complete file name should be linked to the key field, but only the part that appears before the underscore. Make sure the option Show Advanced Options is checked. I select the row in the grid and press Edit Parsing. In this dialog, I need to specify which part of the file name should be retained as key information. This parsing string will omit all text appearing after the underscore. The correct part of the file name will be imported and linked to the key field. In the last step, I need to specify a name for my template. My template is now added to the database. I make sure my template is selected and select spot typing as my experiment type and press next to go to the next step. I confirm the creation of the new entries in the database and I go to the final step. In this last step, I can specify some additional settings for the pre-processing of my trace files. Pressing the Trim Settings button allows me to define the start and stop patterns for the spot typing experiment. The patterns are automatically filled in, so there is no need to change this information here. Pressing the Assembly Settings button allows me to change the assembly settings for the spot typing experiment. I will use the default suggested settings so I can press Cancel to close the dialog. The final step is to click Finish and the software will start assembling the selected trace files. Once the assembly is complete, an overview report will appear. The overview panel displays the entries as rows and the experiments as columns. Each cell provides information about the current status of an assembly project. In my example, most sequences were assembled correctly and the corresponding cells have a green color. One cell has an orange color. It is not required to check this assembly, but still it is recommended. When I click on the cell, the details are updated in the details panel on the right-hand side. I can open the assembler window by double-clicking on a warning message. The consensus sequences shown in the upper line and the individual sequences that contribute to the consensus are displayed below. Using the default assembler settings, a gap in one sequence and a base in the other will insert the gap in the consensus sequence. I can take a look at the curves to check the base calling, or I can screen the consensus sequence for repeat matches. The start and stop signatures are displayed in yellow. Known repeats are shown in green and the name is shown on top of the sequence. Bases that are not assigned to known repeats are shown in red. One repeat has a red color. I can have a look at the nearest repeat matches with the menu item Spot Typing, Show Repeats Plot. When I click on the unknown repeat, a table is displayed with the editing suggestions. Replacing the gap with a D will give the repeat 33 and will result in type 186. Updating the base calling in one of the trace files automatically updates the consensus sequence. The consensus sequence should now have a perfect match with spot type 186. I save the changes and close the assembler window. The cell is updated and is displayed in green. I close the overview report window at file exit. The window can be called again with the menu item Analysis, Sequence Types, Batch Assembly Reports. The entries are displayed in the Database Entries panel and are automatically selected. For each experiment defined in the database, there is a column present in the Experiment Presence panel. A colored dot is displayed if a sequence is present for an entry experiment combination. To view the consensus sequence of a certain entry, I can click on the corresponding colored dot while holding down the Shift key. The assembly window can be called again by clicking on this button. To open the sequence editor, I can just click on the colored dot. The assembly window is called with this button. Information on how to screen the consensus sequences against the repeat sequences is illustrated in another video. Thank you for watching.